स्टूडेंट इन दिस वीडियो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू थिंक और टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक ऑन द रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ अर्थ वर्म. दिस द फाइव मार्क क्वेश्चन इन एग्जाम, इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ अर्थ वर्म. जनरली द अर्थ वर्म आर द मोनोसियस. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मोनोसियस? द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन आर प्रेजेंट इन वन ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड दे आर ऑल्सो पोटेंड्रोम्स. नाउ व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ पोटेंड्रोम्स? द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन प्रेजेंट इन सिंगल ऑर्गेनिज्म बट दे कैन नॉट फर्टिलाइज देयर ओन एग और देन दे ओन ओवा बाय देयर ओन स्पर्म. Now, the male reproductive organ of earthworm. The first organ is testis, which present in all organisms. But in other organisms, there are only two testes are present. But in earthworm, there are four. That means two pair of testes present in segment number 10 and segment number 11. This is the old structure. Round shape structure which present in the segment number 10 and segment number 11. And there a ventrolaterally bends the alimentary canal. It's present, bends the alimentary canal and present on ventrolateral side of body. Now the testis sac, both the testes is enclosed by or enclosed within a sac-like structure. This sac-like structure is known as testis sac. Thus, there are two testis sac situated in the segment number 10 and segment number 11 below the alimentary canal. Now, the seminal vesicles. Seminal vesicles is a white gland-like structure present in the two pair. There are two pair of large white seminal vesicles lying in the segment number 11 and segment number 12 respectively. That means the testes of 10th segment are connected with the 11th number of the segment of seminal vesicle. Or 11th number of segment number 11 testes are connected with the seminal vesicle of 12th segment. Next. Now the spermatozoal funnel. It is a funnel-like structure. And what is the function of spermatozoal? They collect the sperm from the testes and which present bends the testes. There are two pair of ciliated segment and funnel-like structure and one of them lying behind each testes in the same segment enclosed within the testes sac which present inside the testes. The testes sac and present bend the testes and they collect the testes or they collect the sperm from the testes. Next. Now the vasa deferentia or sperm duct which carry the sperm from one place to another place. This duct is known as sperm vasa deferentia. Each funnel leads into a slender ciliated or a duct-like structure. Each funnel which present bends the testes, funnel-like structure, which directly open into a duct-like structure and they continue with a duct-like structure. Inside the or inner lining of the duct contain the many ciliated structure and a thread-like structure which is known as sperm duct or vasa deferentia. Two vasa deferentia of same side run close together posteriorly along the ventral body wall to the 18th segment and join the prosthetic duct. Both the side of the duct run parallelly and closely together and directly joined or directly open into the prostate duct which present in the segment number 18. Next. Now the prostate gland. The prostate gland or prostate duct open into the prostate gland. First of all, vasa deferentia open into the 18th segment and connected to the prostate duct, and prostate duct directly open into the prostate gland. Prostate gland are a pair of dirty white, flat, solid and irregular and lobulated mass. It is a white, dirty white color, irregular in shape and flat structure, which present into the 16th or 17th segment and extend up to the 20th or 21st segment. Next. Now the accessory gland, which is the important part of the reproductive system of earthworm. In each of the segments, 17th and 19th, is a found a pair of rounded, white, fluffy structure or fluffy mass. The accessory gland on the ventrolateral body wall on the either side of the nerve cord. This is present on the either side of the nerve cord. Next. Now, the female reproductive system. Female reproductive system consists of main four organs. The first one is ovary, ovidial funnel, oviduct and spermatheca. Spermatheca is a storage of sperm and ovaries and ovidial funnel, which are the ovaries form the ova and ovidial funnel, and oviduct carries the ova one place to another place. Now the first structure or first organ is ovary. A pair of small white digital ovaries lies in the 13th segment and directly attached to the posterior part or posterior facing of the 12th or 13th segment septum. And directly attached to the 13th segment or septum of 13th segment. In front of it, on each either side of the ventral nerve cord. One pair of ovary which present either side of the nerve cord. Each ovary is a white compact mass made of the finger-like process in which ova are arranged in a linear series in a various stage of development. The ovas are present. In some ova are in the small size, some are the large size. Depending upon the size, we can say the ova are in which stage of the development. The ova are the large. Then we can say this, the ova are completely developed or mature ova. The ova are the small. This ova are in a primitive development stage. Now, the ovidial funnel. Ovidial funnel is a simply funnel like a saucer shaped structure which present bent to each side of the ovary. Now, ovidial funnel is a simply saucer like structure which present bent to the ovidial funnel with a much folded and ciliated margin. Lies immediately behind each ovary in the 13th segment. Here we can see the structure of the ovary and the ova, which is in the different stage of development. The large ova are completely developed, small ova are in the primitive or starting developing stage. Next. Oviducts. Each oviducal funnel leads behind into a short conical ciliated tube, the oviduct. The oviduct is a simple duct like structure which carries the ova. It opens to exterior through the female genital aperture. Now, female genital aperture is situated mid-ventrally on the 14th segment of the body. On the ventral surface of the body, at the segment number 14, there is a opening of female reproductive organ or female genital aperture. Now, the last structure is spermatheca. This is the sac-like structure, which contain a large sac and a small sac in the side. It is a sac-like structure. The function of this structure is just only to store the sperms of the opposite earthworm. When they copulate, the sperm are temporarily transported to this structure, which known as spermatheca. And when the cocoon formation is start, the sperm are deposited into the cocoon or the egg capsule structure. Thank you.